Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Dear students, I am Aftab Alam Zikriya Mukadam from Mechanical Engineering Department. Today we are here for discussion of design procedure of turnbuckle. As we know that turnbuckle is an adjustable screw joint which consists of two types of threaded rods. One threaded rod have left hand threads and other have right hand threads. Both the threaded rods are screwed to the coupler and coupler nut assembly of turnbuckle. So these joints can be applicable in case of connection of two tie rods, that is connection of wire cables, in case of marine applications, in case of jib cranes to tighten the various poles which consist of transmission lines and some electric wire poles. Then few applications such as in wrestling rings, then in some roof trusses and connection of railway wagon. So here we have the important design procedure which have been performed in various steps. So just look on to this important video. These are the important nomenclature for this adjustable screw joint, that is turnbuckle. So first one is DC, that is core diameter of screw thread. Then next one is DO, that is outer diameter of screw thread. Then next one is capital D, so capital D is diameter of coupler nut. Then L, small L, that is length of coupler nut. Then next one is D1, that is inside diameter of coupler. Then D2, that is outside diameter of coupler. Then small t, that is thickness of coupler. Then sigma t and tau are the permissible stresses in tension and shear. Then next one is sigma cr, that is crushing stress. Small n, number of threads. Step number 1 is failure of threaded rod in tension. Due to tensile load on this turnbuckle assembly, the threads of this screw will be failed perpendicular to the applied load. That is, threads will fail at root. So the area correspond to, that is resisting area of this failure, will be the core area of this screw thread. So for this core area, the diameter responsible is DC, that is core diameter. So area that is resisting to that particular tensile stress will be, area is equal to pi by 4 into DC square. So tensile strength of this threaded rod can be determined as P, that is design load, PD is equal to tensile stress into area. So PD, that is design load, is equal to sigma t into A. So PD is equal to sigma t into pi by 4 DC square. From this equation, this DC, that is core diameter of screw thread, can be determined. Step number 2 is failure of coupler nut in shear. Due to tensile load, stronger screw will shear off the threads from coupler nut parallel to the applied load. So therefore, the thread circumference of nut will be removed by stronger screw. So area resisting to that particular shear failure will be the circumferential area of nut which is removed by screw. So that circumferential area A is equal to pi DO into length of that coupler nut. So upon substituting this value of area, we can get the shear strength for coupler nut. So PD is equal to tau into area. So PD is equal to tau into A. So PD is equal to tau into pi DO into L. So this is the shear strength of coupler nut. Step number 3 is failure of screw in shear. Due to that tensile load PD, screw will be sheared off by stronger nut. So here coupler nut will remove threads from circumference of screw. So area resisting to that particular shear failure will be circumferential area of screw thread. So that circumferential area A is equal to pi DC into L. Upon substituting this value of area, we can get shear strength. So shear strength of this screw can be determined as PD is equal to tau into A. So PD is equal to tau into pi DC into L. This is the shear strength of screw. Step number 4 is crushing failure between coupler nut and screw. As we know that due to mating contact between threads of coupler nut and screw, there will be crushing. So area resisting to that particular contact failure will be projected area. So projected area between the nuts, threads and screw threads can be given as A is equal to pi by 4 DO, outer diameter of thread, that is square, minus core diameter of thread square, multiply by number of threads per mm length into length of coupler nut. So upon substituting this value of area, we can get crushing strength, that is PD is equal to crushing stress into projected area. So PD is equal to sigma CR into A. So sigma CR is the crushing stress of this particular coupler and screw threads. Then PD can be determined as PD is equal to sigma CR into pi by 4 DO square minus DC square into N into L, where this crushing stress sigma CR should be in allowable limit of crushing stress of material of coupler nut or material of screw. Step number 5 is failure of coupler nut in tension. So due to the applied tensile force, coupler nut will be failed perpendicular to that load. So area resisting to that tension will be area is equal to pi by 4 capital D square minus DO square. So this is the area which will be resisting to that particular tensile failure. So upon substituting this value of area, the tensile strength of coupler nut can be determined as PD is equal to sigma T into A. So PD is equal to sigma T into pi by 4 capital D square minus DO square, where this sigma T, that is tensile stress, should be in allowable limit of tensile stress for material of coupler nut. Step number 6 is tensile failure of coupler. So due to applied tensile load, coupler will be failed perpendicular to that load. So area resisting to that tension will be area is equal to pi by 4 into outer diameter of coupler, that square, minus inner diameter of coupler square. So area is equal to pi by 4 D2 square minus D1 square. Upon substituting this value, tensile strength for coupler, that can be determined as PD is equal to tensile stress into area. So PD is equal to sigma T into area. So PD is equal to sigma t into pi by 4 d2 square minus d1 square, where this tensile stress sigma t should be in allowable limit of tensile stress for material of coupler. In this way, we can determine the tensile strength of coupler. These are the few important empirical relations which are used in design of turnbuckle, that are length of coupler nut, then diameter of coupler nut, then outside diameter of coupler, inside diameter of coupler, length of coupler, then length of coupler nut and thickness of coupler. So for that, these are the few important empirical relations. Hope so, dear students, you understood this important design procedure of turnbuckle, where we have designed important elements like threaded screw, then coupler nut and coupler. So inshallah, in next session we'll cover some more important design procedure. To view more such videos, subscribe my channel Aftab Alam Mukaddam. Thank you all of you for watching.